Hey guys, Jim Stargazer here. Over here for the third day at the Expona audio show here at the Renaissance Center in Schaumburg, Illinois. So just making this quick intro video for you guys. So today's the third day, and I'm probably gonna have two or three videos, so I'm just gonna make one intro video for all three. So it'll be the same video like this for all three videos. So just wanna let you guys know. I saw yesterday one of the videos had a block on it. So I had to omit the sound and put some just non-copyright sounds to it. So some things like the Eagles, the group called the Eagles, their music, they just don't let nobody use it. Not even if you pay them. You have to actually do like a whole thing to pay them, and then they'll let you use it. But yeah, so sorry about that, guys. One of the speakers isn't showing the real sound. I try to leave it as best as I can. So. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna go in here. It looks like the line's not started yet. I came a little early today, so I'm gonna go up to the sixth floor. So I got sixth floor down to one, and then the convention center to hit for you guys today. And then I'll put up the videos. I still got day two to put up, and then day three. So just bear with me while I start editing these videos, guys. All right, thanks.
Listen to this song,
clear audio,
and I recall my own childhood. Remember the time when my grandma was by my side. Her hands were chapped but tender. Her hands were the roof of the house where
precious is high. I am fate, scars, I am human.
No question, that was a vinyl that turned on.
Thank you. I had to go up because I didn't know you were, you know, freaking out. But it was really funny. And
introduce the system. So this is a co-exhibiting room of ESD Acoustic and Aurelic. This is our flagship system named the Super Dragon. It's quite complicated, so I go one by one. This is our CD transport with a controller and a separate power supply. This line is all for the separate power supply of this line. This is our DAC. This is the preamplifier. These two are our active analog crossover. They have 5 ways, and each way you can adjust level, phase, and slope. So from there, it goes to five amplifiers on each side, so 10 in total. They are all single and solid state, 10 watts, and they are using carbon silicon MOS tubes. So very, very unique structure. There are also two sets of subwoofers, which they have amplifiers of their own. They are 500 watts, so it's 6 ways in total. The subwoofers are in charge of 18 to 50 hertz, and the big horn is in charge of 50 to 100 hertz. This is from 100 to 500 hertz. The mid-range is from 500 to 2000 hertz. These two are from 2000 to 8000 hertz. from 8,000 to 52,000 hertz. So 6-way and 10 units on each side. And okay, so all the horns are using carbon fiber. We cannot see the carbon fiber right now because this is a special version with Chinese lacquer finish. But with standard version, you can see the surface. But we can see also carbon fiber here. Carbon fiber is very resonance free. We are the world's first to produce carbon fiber horns, so that it does not create the so-called horn sounding while playing, because the horn does not vibrate themselves. For example, if you listen to other normal horn systems and you put your hands on the horns while it's playing, you can sense the resonance very clearly. But for carbon fiber horns, that's not the case. So the mid-range tweeter and super tweeter all use foil brilliant diaphragms from True Extent, and our base units are all using titanium sandwich diaphragms developed by ourselves. So they are ultra stiff. I can put my whole weight on a single diaphragm without deforming it. So that brings huge benefit, because for normal speakers, the paper cones, when they move up and down, they deform themselves. That is the main source of total harmonic distortion. But for us, we create only 0.5% of total harmonic distortion at 20 hertz. So that's a very very good step. And for mid-range, it's only 0.1%. So ultra-low total harmonic distortion across all bandwidth. All other units are using field coil, aka electromagnet. So we know that most speakers are permanent magnet. The benefit is that it can go to ultra-high magnetic density with permanoid in it to transform the flux. So all the drivers can go to 2.4 Tesla. That is also why we have four boxes here for separate power supply to provide for the power of the copper coils inside the drivers. So that way, in comparison, most speakers like 1.2 to 1.5 Tesla, so it's like a Lamborghini compared to normal cars, it's very high power. Okay, so many people may wonder, we have so many electronics, would it be very inconvenient to turn everything on? That is not the case, because there are two central power supply in the back. And turning everything on would just need two button pushing. Everything is connected in, and it's in sequence. So turning on will be in sequence as well. So you don't have to worry about burning anything up. Like I mentioned, it's Chinese lacquer special version. We have introduction of Chinese lacquer outside on the brochure. So this system here is $4 million. And for standard setup, without the Chinese lacquer, it's 1.2 million. So this is our flagship system named Super Dragon. Aside from that, we have Phoenix, Crane, and Panda, which is over there. It's a bookshelf speaker, which you can also see the standard setup's paint. It's the same as Mercedes-Benz. And we have smaller ones named Aviator, which is a Bluetooth speaker. We also have headset named Kirin. If you're interested in our products, please visit esdacoustic.com. You can also fetch a name card over here, which you can see the website, and also feel free to contact us through email, which is also on the name card. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Alright guys, looks like this is a trading hall, so I thought I'd take a video and work my way through and show you guys what they got, you know? Got phonographs. Got phonographs. So these are for the guys who can't rent out the big room, so they come into the main hall where everybody shares the cost. We got over here. Interconnect cable. Some nice phonographs. I really like these phonographs. We got some demo stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm on a plane. I have no way to take anything home, so. Power conditioner. I don't know what this is. Oh, a record cleaner. Oh, I need to make a short on this. Okay, back to recording. This is nice. We got over here. Living stereo. Let me zoom out. Thought I was zoomed out already. Horace. Via blue cables. These are in a lot of the rooms. Looks like a little snack area back here. Snack area. Let's go see what they're talking about over here. Some kind of masterclass theater.
And you might, if you're not measuring what's going on and controlling these torque forces in your arm, you're going to start blaming the cartridge. So your response is to
It's about phonograph cartridge.
And maybe it's still a problem. Now you're going to start really blaming the cartridge. No. Cartridges are almost never to blame for sibilance and mistracking. Almost never. It's almost always a cartridge, a tone arm problem. The cartridges unfairly get the blame because people aren't main watching the simple moment of physics. It's just physics. There's nothing magical about it. We're ignoring the fact that will create and might create its own horizontal torque or by the way, static.
We got planar three.
So, there are a couple of things, and I'm going to get to ETA if you're going to bring that to this hour.
I'm actually looking for a six.
Okay, stylus rating. That's the angular relationship.
And the rest is like records over here, so you guys can look for records. CDs, sleeves for the records. This is pretty damn cool. Now this could be my thumbnail. Yeah, this is cool. This is sick, guys. Oh, I gotta stop this video and make it short. This is too cool. Let's continue with that. They're pretty cool. Find some cool things in the show. Yeah, it looks like a big chunk of this is records, though. Headphones. I'm not a big fan of headphones like that. I'm more about speakers. I have a pair of those new Bowers PX8s I got from the show yesterday. Looks like that's it. We flipped the video. Alright guys, looks like that's it. Looks like that's the end of the show for me. I did all the rooms. I tried to do all the rooms for you guys. I did all the convention rooms. Yeah, so this is day three, end of day three. So this is going to be at least three videos, guys. So I'm just going to use this same ending video for all three videos so I don't have to make another one. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching the videos. Don't forget to check out the rest. I'll put the links above. Like I said in the other videos, and check out some other videos I got coming up. I got I'm going to be doing some speaker power sale coming up this week, and they're going to be shipping me an amplifier to do unboxing. I'm going to put it into the hard bottle. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching the video.